The GoTo feature is just like it sounds. You can quickly get to a cell by using this feature. And to pull it up, come up here on the Home tab, go to the Editing group, click on Find and Select, and it's right there, GoTo. You can see that when I hover over it, it gives you the pop-up, also gives you the shortcut keys Control G. So you can do Control G or click on GoTo, or better yet, let me close out, you can hit the F5 key on the keyboard and it brings up the same window. So if I want to go to a cell, I can come down here and reference the cell. Like if I want to go to Z2000, type in Z2000. And before I click OK and it takes me to it, notice the cell that I'm coming from. It's A3, so when I click Okie Dokie, takes me right to it. But when I hit F5 again, it remembers where I came from. Cool. Let's go ahead and select it, click OK, and hey, we're right back. Well, if I scroll up a couple of rows, now I can see everything. We're right back where we started. Now you could say, well, can I just come up here in the name box and say I want to go to cell C2 and hit enter? Yes, but there are other features that you can use when using the GoTo feature. That's just to give you the basics. For example, when you hit the F5 key on the keyboard, it remembers where you've been. So we were in A3, then we went to Z2000, and now we went over to C2. So if I click OK and I go to B5 and I hit F5, it remembers where I went, which was C2, and so it can keep track of it, but also it'll list all the named ranges or named cells that we have within our workbook. For example, what is a named range or cell? I talk about this in a later training video, but for the sake of this exercise to see it listed in the GoTo window, I'm going to go over it just a little bit. By default, any cell that you select has got its own name, and this one is G5. But you can come up here in the name box and say, well, let me give it a new name. In fact, let's do it for commission, because when I want to get to the commission cell, I'm not going to really reference it by F3, but I can remember commission. So I can come up here and click in F3 and type in COMM to override it, and then underscore, and let's call it commission 1 because I have a second cell over here that has commission as well. So we'll call it COM1 and COM2. And then when I'm done typing it, and make sure you don't have any spaces because it doesn't like spaces, hit enter on the keyboard and it accepts it. So now the cell has a new name. Well, it doesn't forget the old because you can always come, well, let me click off. Come up in here and type in F3 and hit enter, it takes you right to it. Or when I click off of it, click on the drop down arrow and select COM1. Or you can hit the F5 key on the keyboard and guess what it lists as well? It lists any cells that have a new name or a range that has a new name. And we'll cover that a bit more in a later training video, but again, for the sake of this exercise, I wanted to make sure that you understand that when you look at this, you're like, what the heck is that? That's not a cell reference, that's a name. Well, it is referencing a cell, but by a name that you or somebody else gave it, or a range of cells. And then finally, you've got something special. Go ahead and click on that. And you can select all the comments that are in the workbook, the constants, the formulas. And if I go ahead and say for the formulas, I want all those that contain numbers, text, logicals, errors, click okie dokie. Hey, look at that. It selected every single cell that has a formula in it. So if I want to go ahead and do a quick update and identify those formulas by formatting them, like let's say in bold, isn't that a lot faster than me trying to go ahead and click and drag and select these ranges and then come up here? Just hit F5 and say that you want to select formulas. Oh, and don't forget, if you want to be able to see those cells, the formulas they're in and not the results of them, you got Control Tilde. It expands it and shows the contents or the formulas in the cells. So that way you can see that these cells that I had selected through F5 actually are cells that contain formulas in them. And then to hide it, Control Tilde again, and it collapses. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like my video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you subscribe to my YouTube channel, as soon as I upload a new video, you'll be notified instantly, and you can do that by coming over here and clicking on my face. You can also click here to support me, so for $2 a month, you can have access to over 2,700 training videos, all ad-free, and for a few bucks more, you can have access to my exercises, instructor notes, quizzes, certificate of completion, and a whole lot more.